James, the book that's going to teach us that what we do matters. Here's some videos. And these are the chapters, the sessions. 1 through 5. The session 1 is how you respond to hardship matters. 2, your response to God's word matters. How you see others matters. And what you say matters. And how you live matters. Everything matters. There's a lot of similarity between the book of James and the words of Jesus. So you're going to see comparison in this book. These are the things that I liked about this welcome. Our genuine love for God expresses itself through faith and action. What we do matters. That's from the introduction video. How to use this guide. And then this is session 1. I listened to the video the first 14 minutes. This is my bookmarker, the paper tissue. That's where I'm writing down what minute I'm on. Anyways. So, just want to share from that first video how the things that caught my attention, basically. And how God speaks to us through His Word. And there are things that we realize that we're not doing the way God wants us to. Or we're not reacting the way God would like us to. And sometimes we try to change and then we kind of stop. And so anyways, this book of James is very good because of that. Because it creates that awareness of how, you know, what God's expectations of us is and where we're going to be blessed in our way of thinking and reactions if we follow His word. So here there are more notes. And I like this that she said in the video, Jesus is always pursuing those of us who are skeptics or unbelievers of certain things, believers in general, or certain areas of our lives. Jesus is always pursuing us. Why? Because He loves us. And He is showing His mercy over our lives. And He wants us to get better, to be better, and to be more like Him. Because when we reach that level, we're going to experience a wholeness in Jesus. We're going to be so different. Peaceful, loving, and just live in peace altogether. And these are my notes here. In case you want to read. Another thing that caught my attention is basically realizing that none of us can escape life without problems. But when we do face them, we can choose what our response will be. That's totally up to us. We can react with bitterness, blame, rage. But Jesus challenged us to practice defiant joy. Defiant joy. Man, that's hard. But that's what God wants us to do. And when we focus on that, we're going to see a whole different level of us, of who we are. We're going to see our potential. There's also something here that says, another note that I made from her video, active engagement of the mind in which we choose to place our trust in the character and competence of God. Defiant joy is that active engagement of our mind that we choose to place our trust in the character and competence of God. So what that means is, they find joy is that no matter what happens to me, I know God has me. No matter what happens to me, I know God is with me and he's going to make things work. When we know the character of God and we know that God has, his plans are perfect. His plans are good, goodness for us. When we know that and we believe it in our hearts, when we face challenges or things happen, we're going to trust him. We're going to place our minds here. We're going to say, Lord, you got me. You got this. Help me through this and help me act the way you would act. This is such a great book. Anyways, so this is pretty much how the book goes. It just asks a lot of questions for us to answer based on the writers. It's a really nice book. And you can even color that if you want to. I love that. And then in the back, it has some verses to memorize that you can cut out for every week, every session. There's a verse, and there's also like, this is like a summary session by session that you can write down any prayer request and the main, you know, lesson. And then here, I like this where it compares the letter of James with the Sermon on the Mount, what Jesus said. Very nice book. It's not that big. It's 150 something pages. And this is the study.